I have tons of files to move, and it will take me ages to do that. Or it won't. Repetitive and boring tasks. This is exactly what the shell and command line shine at. In this mini-series, I will show you three ways of moving a bunch of files in no time, just by using a few commands. Very probably there is other solutions than the one I will present here. So if you have any idea, don't hesitate to share that by commenting below. Anyway, here's my need. For now, I have my movie files scattered among several subdirectories. Subtitle files are .sub, and movie files are .mp4 or .mkv. But my new media player settings require to have all movies in a video folder and all subtitles in a subtitle folder. Moving all those files by hand will be terribly time-consuming. But using the shell, it is quite easy to achieve that. First, I have to know the command to move files is the mv command. And using mv, I could move files one by one, but it would actually be less efficient than doing that using the graphical user interface. But the good news is we can do better because the shell supports something called Glob pattern. That means instead of typing an exact file name, you can give to the shell a description of the file made of wildcards and plain characters. And the shell will build itself the list of files matching that description. The most useful wildcard in Glob patterns is a star that will match anything. For example, all files ending in .mp4 will be written *.mp4, and all files ending in .mkv will be written *.mkv. In other words, to move all my files at once, I could write but I've only moved files from the current working directory, that is, the movies directory. So, do I have to do that again and again for each subdirectory? Well, I could do that, but that would be quite boring soon. So I will use a star wildcard again, but this time to say to the shell to consider files inside any directory. That is, inside directories with any name. Did you see that? In only a few seconds, I moved several hundreds of files. Not bad, isn't it? Well, the only drawback here is this will not work if we have several levels of subdirectories. So in the next video of the series, we will see the classic solution to solve that issue. If you don't want to miss that, don't forget to subscribe to this channel.